Myself Ajay Gupta, and today I am going to teach you chapter 2 of class 11, that is form of business organization. So according to the form of business organization, there are two parts, that is non-incorporated and incorporated. Under non-incorporated, there are three organizations. First one is your sole proprietorship, second one is your partnership, and third one is your joint stock company. And under incorporated, there are two parts, that is cooperative society and joint stock company. These are the main form of business organization which are prevailing in India. So we are going to start with sole proprietorship. So what is sole proprietorship? As per its name, sole means single and proprietor means business. So it refers to that form of business organization which is owned by a single person, and all the profit and loss will be borne by that single person only. So that is a sole proprietorship. Merits, quick decision, that is the most important benefit in sole proprietorship business, that he can take all the decision himself. He has to not to consult any person or take any other references. So he can take all the decisions himself. Direct motivation, as much work he will be doing, that much he will be earning. Suppose if he is not doing the work, he is closed down his shop, then he will not get any benefit. So he will be directly motivated. Another one is the easy formation. That is the most important benefit of sole proprietorship, because there is no formalities which has to be fulfilled by forming the sole proprietorship. No registration is required, no documents are required. Anyone can start the business at any place. As there are some merits, there are some demerits also. That is limited sources of capital. That is the most important limitation of sole proprietorship, because all the money has to be invested by the sole proprietor only. He cannot take money from outside. Suppose he want to take the loan, he should have some assets. Against that loan assets only he can take some loan. Another is unlimited liability. That is the most important demerit. Suppose he has taken a loan from somewhere, from the bank, but he is not able to repay that loan from the business property, then his personal property can also be sold or taken by the bank. Another demerit is unstable existence. That is also a problem in the sole proprietor. Suppose the sole proprietor get ill or have a death, then the business has to be closed down because there is no one other to run the business. That is the demerits of sole proprietorship. Another form is partnership. Partnership, as its name shows, there should be minimum two persons to start a business. It refers to that form of business organization in which two or more than two persons willingly join and agree to run some legal business. That is the most important. It should be legal. No illegal business can be called as a partnership. Here also there are some merits, easy formation. Here also we can form it easily. Only minimum two members are required and maximum 100 members can be there. Balanced decision, that is also an important merit of this, because all the decision will be taken jointly. No single individual can take the decision in this business. In partnership, the decision has to be taken by all the members. Division of risk, that is also a very important benefit. As in sole proprietorship, all the risk lies with the sole proprietor only. Any loss, that has to be borne by him only, alone. But in partnership, the loss will be divided between all the partners in the ratio agreed upon. So whatever ratio they are having, according to that only, they will be dividing the profit or losses. And there are some demerits like unlimited liability. Here also, the liability is unlimited. Suppose they are not able to repay the loan taken from the bank, then their personal property can also be used. And it is not important that all the members' personal property will be used. One person's can be used or other persons can be used. Then limited resources, here also they have a limited resource. Whatever capital they are investing, that has to be invested by themselves only. If they have to take the loan from outside, they have to have the assets. Then only they can take the loan. Again, lack of continuity, that is also a problem in partnership, because sometimes there may be a conflict between the partner. Then the partnership has to be closed down. And they cannot enter other partner also without the permission of all the partner. So that is the problem in partnership. Third form of business organization is joint Hindu family business. As its name shows, it should be from a single family. That is from one family only, and three generations can participate in this type of business. It refers to that business organization under which all the members jointly of joint Hindu family carry a business under the control of Mukhya, that is the head of the family. He is also known as Karta. Because in joint Hindu family business, all the decision will be taken by the head. The head is known as Karta, and other partners are known as co-partners. Merit, easy to start because all the work has to be done within the family only. All the family members are the partner. As anyone take the birth, he becomes a partner of the company. Secrecy, that is also very important in this, because they can keep everything secret. They have to not to publish anything, no profit they have to show, or the way they are doing the business, they have to not to show anything. Another is prompt decision. That is because all the decision will be taken by the help of Karta only. So he can take the decision quickly. But it is also a demerit also, because sometime Karta take wrong decision because he is not consulting to other, and the loss has to be bear by all the partners. All the partner has to bear the loss. So that is might be a disadvantage also. Then demerit, here also limited resources, because all the money will be invested by the members only. Whosoever is there in the membership, they will invest their money. Limited, unlimited liability. The partner has a limited liability, but the Karta has unlimited liability. As I told you, that as if they have taken any wrong decision, and because of that, the loss is there in the business, then it has to be suffered by everyone. Lack of manager skill, this is also a problem, because it is not important that Karta has a management decision, power also. He might not take correct decision in the business. So sometimes he might take the wrong decision, and because of that only the loss has to be borne by all the partner. Now we have a incorporated form of business organization. Here the first one is your cooperative society. So cooperative society kya hai? It referred to that voluntary association of persons who joined together with the motive of welfare of the member. That means they are not working for the profit. They are only working for the welfare of the society and for the members. Here profit is not given to the partners also. Whosoever is there in joint cooperative society, minimum 10% should be required. Then only we can start a cooperative society. Merit, easy formation. We can form it easily. There are different type of cooperative society which can be formed, like consumer cooperative, farmer cooperative, producer cooperative. Different type of cooperative societies can be opened. It depends upon the type of work which we are doing. So if we are opening a consumer cooperative, so any 10 consumer can join together to open a cooperative society. Over there they can start their work, they can invest their money. The main benefit the partner which they are getting is they are getting the goods at a lesser price. When they are giving to the outsider, they are giving at a higher price, including some profit. And all the profit is reinvested in the business only. Some part of the profit is given to the partner who has invested their money, and they have a one voting right. Because in corporate society, they have to select some persons who will operate the business. So every member, it does not include how much capital you have invested. So one person has one voting right only. And minimum 10 persons are there. Maximum is no limit, but after forming the cooperative society, we can fix the maximum limit. Stability, it stables for a longer period. The most benefit in which in cooperative society is that it is helped by the government. Government is also providing help, like tax concession. They are giving tax concession to the cooperative societies. They are also giving the loan at a easier or a lesser interest. That is the benefit which a cooperative society is having. Demerit, lack of capital, another problem, because for capital they have to depend upon the government only, and whatever money can be invested, that can be invested by the members only. Cash trading, that is also a problem in cooperative society. All the work is done on cash basis only, but as poor people are also there, sometimes they cannot afford to buy the goods on cash basis. So that is also a problem in cooperative society. Next is your lack of motivation. That is also a problem in corporate because they are not getting profit. So that's why they are not motivated to do more work. They are doing it as a part-time work only. So that's why they are not motivated in this type of business. Last one is your company organization. Company, as its name shows, it is minimum 7 members are required to form a cooperative organization and company organization, and there is no maximum limit. A company, kya hoti hai? A company is an artificial person created by law having separate entity with a common seal and perpetual existence. Perpetual existence means if any person dies or if any person retires or if any person leaves the organization, the company goes on. It is not closed until or unless they are fulfilling the law merits, limited liability. That is the most important merit in this. As much money you have invested, that is the only liability you are having in the organization. Share transferability, that is also a benefit in this. That means you can buy the share of the company and you can sell the shares in the stock market. That is the most important benefit. It is not important that you have to be with one company only. You can buy the shares, and as many person is buying the share, they become the member of the company. Continuity, it keeps on continue. It does not get closed down unless or until it not fulfills the law. Whatever rules has been applicable to the company, if they are not fulfilling, then only the company has to be closed. And it will be dissolved by the government only. Demerits, difficulty in formation, that is the most important demerit. After fulfilling many formalities, then only the company can be incorporated. That means registration is compulsory. Unless or until the company is not registered, we cannot start the business. So that is the most important demerit of the company organization. Then lack of secrecy, that is also important because they have to publish all the details about the company, whatever profit they are earning, the way they are doing the business, all the balance sheet has to be published and it has to be shown to the every person, whosoever is the shareholder. So that's why they cannot keep anything secret. Another, excessive government control, that is also a big disadvantage in company organization, because whatever decision they have to take, first of all, they have to take the permission from the government. Suppose they have to issue shares. So first of all, they have to take the permission from SEBI, that is the Security Exchange Board of India. From there, they have to take the permission, and after that only, they can issue their shares. So whatever they have to do, first of all, they have to take the permission from the government, and that's why government is having more interference in this type of organization.